Welcome to Dansplaining Video. I'm going to show you how to use Final Cut Pro to draw a line that appears to track a moving object. Now, this video is the Final Cut Pro version of a video I did previously on how to do this with DaVinci Resolve. So you should go watch that after you've watched this video. Or go watch that video and then come back and watch this one. I've already created the library and project for this video. I haven't. I've created the library, but not the project. The arc 3. And add the video to the timeline. Hit Shift Z to spread it out. And then I'm going to scrub through this video to the point where my hand starts to move. I know about where I'm going to draw the line. To actually draw the line, I need to add a solid color. So I'm going to select Generators, Solids, and Custom, and drag the custom solid to the timeline and put it on top and drag it out so that it's the same length as my clip, approximately. And then I need to select the effect. And just to give us more room, I don't need to see this panel anymore. So I'm going to turn that off up here on the right. This control turns that off and back on. I'm going to leave it off. And from the effects, I want to select masks. Click on masks. And I want to draw mask, so I'm going to drag the draw mask onto this background. And while I'm thinking about it, I should change the color of the background. And I'm going to select yellow. Go back to the video inspector. Here's my draw mask, but so that I can see what's behind the background, I'm going to reduce the opacity of this background so that I can see what's happening there. Now in DaVinci Resolve, you can use a B-spline to just draw a line, and that makes the mask. But with Final Cut Pro, you can't do that. You have to have a shape where you basically draw a line, and the line has to, the end point of the line has to meet the beginning of the line. So to do that, we're going to change the draw mask shape type from Bezier to B-spline. And then I can start drawing my line. Click lines or click dots to create the B-spline and the approximate arc. And it's need some adjustment. So it's easier to adjust this now before I've made the complete shape, because otherwise I'll have twice as many lines I have to move. You'll see what I mean in a moment. Okay, it's still not quite right, but get these back here a bit. Okay, that's close enough. Now I have to continue with the B spline to complete the shape, and I'm going to add these lines close to where the, or add these dots close to where the previous dots were. It'll make a little bit of more sense when this is completed. And you can see, if you've already seen the DaVinci Resolve video, you can see already tell this doesn't really look as good as it does in DaVinci Resolve, where you only have to create a line with a B spline instead of having to create a three-dimensional shape. So this will take quite a bit more adjustment because you have to move twice as many dots. And I'm going to turn the opacity back up. And to assist in adjusting this, I'm going to increase the size of this a little, zoom in, maybe a little bit more. And this is going to be time consuming, so I'm probably going to edit most of this out. So you won't have to watch me do this. Zoom back out to fit the window. Nope. Okay. So the line looks the way we want it to. Looks the way I want, at least it looks the way I want it to. Now I have to add a second draw mask to hide this line completely and then animate the second draw mask to reveal the line as my hand moves. I'm going to click on Draw Mask, drag it onto the timeline. You can see over here in the inspector, I now have two draw masks. The B-spline draw mask that we just finished drawing, and now we have a second mask, and we're going to leave that mask as type Bezier. And I'm going to draw that mask starting in the center and clicking two points near the beginning of the line, up near the top right, top left, bottom left, and then join the mask right here at the beginning dot. And since the purpose of this mask is to hide the yellow line, I'm going to click on Invert. You have to be very careful when you have multiple draw masks on the same layer. Make sure that you're actually changing the mask, the draw mask that you think you are. In fact, I'm going to hide this one, make it a little less likely I'll change that one by mistake. Now we want to start creating control points, so I'm going to click on this we want to create automatic keyframes. So click on this diamond here to add a keyframe. And instead I hid the draw mask. Okay. So now every time we move the playhead and move control points, it'll create automatic keyframes. I'm going to scrub forward a few frames and then start moving these control points to reveal the line. So I've revealed part of the line there and it doesn't look the way I want it to. I want the line to trail behind my hand. So I need to scrub back to one of these frames and back up these control points a little bit. And then keep adjusting it until it looks the way I want it to. And this can be time consuming, but it works a lot better than a tracker for this kind of thing. A tracker needs really high contrast, slow movement. If an object moves too fast or the something. Now we're going to just keep moving ahead, move the control points. And this dot up here is going to start causing problems. So I'm going to move it over here. And just keep checking this, adjusting the control points until the line looks the way you want. Seems like this was a little bit easier, a little bit less tedious on DaVinci Resolve. Okay, so we're almost done. Just a few more steps, a few more movements of the control points. I just made a really big mistake here. Okay, one final adjustment of the control points. One of the problems I have with Final Cut Pro is a lot of times when I click on one of these control points, Final Cut Pro will select that control point plus one next adjacent to it. And sometimes it'll select the whole thing. And when I'm trying to drag a single control point, it drags the whole shape. And when you do that, you just have to hit on a Mac, it's Command Z to undo that last movement. On a PC, it's Control Z. I think. So just some final adjustments here. Let me go to that one control point over here. I should show you. So that one control point that created a keyframe that's out of whack, and I just don't want that keyframe anymore. So you can go back one keyframe or forward one keyframe. And this keyframe I want to delete. So I'll click this minus, and that deletes that keyframe. So now this looks good. So I'm satisfied with that. I would consider this done. And so this is how you would use Final Cut Pro to draw a line that appears to track a moving object. And I think we're done. If you liked this video or found it helpful, tap thumbs up. If you didn't like this video and didn't find it helpful, tap thumbs down with a really big hammer.